So in this video, we will study about the concept called the solubility. So what is this solubility? Solubility is to be studied under a particular temperature. So by keeping temperature constant, we have to study the solubility of a solution. That means whatever the solute that we are going to add into the solvent, so that the solute undergoes dissolution in the solvent, it will form a solution. So in this solution, at a given temperature, maximum amount of solute has dissolved in the specified quantity of solvent. So such term can be taken as the solubility. What is solubility? At a given temperature, maximum amount of solute has dissolved in the specified quantity of solvent. That is called solubility. And what are factors which affect the solubility? So factors affecting solubility. So what are the factors which affect the solubility? There were four different factors which affect the solubility. So which are those? Nature of solute. Nature of solute. Second one is nature of solvent. Then the third one is temperature. And the fourth one is the pressure. So how can we explain the solubility by using the nature of solute? So how this nature of solute will affect the value of solubility? So to explain the nature of solute, so we have to consider the nature of solute also. That means in the preparation of a solution, we are going to take both solute as well as solvent. So if the solute is the polar in nature, if the solute is polar in nature, then the solvent should also be polar. So solute is polar in nature, then the solvent that we are going to dissolve this solute should also be polar in nature. Then only the solubility of the solute in the solvent will be known. So if the solute is non-polar in nature, then the solvent should also be non-polar. That means we are going to explain the effect of solute, nature of solute and nature of solvent on the solubility by considering both the factors. That means if the solute is polar in nature, then the solvent should also be polar in nature. So that the solute will undergo maximum dissolution at the soluble in the solvent. So if the solute is non-polar in nature, then that non-polar solute will undergo more soluble in the non-polar solvent. Next, to explain the effect of temperature on the solubility, so we are going to take the type of reaction, type of solubility reaction. So if the solubility process is exothermic, and also if the solubility process is endothermic, so what will happen to the solubility? So if the process is exothermic, according to Lee Chartier's principle. So exothermic means the value of delta H will be negative. And in the endothermic, the value of delta H will be positive. So during exothermic reaction, according to Lee Chartier's principle, whenever temperature is increased, according to Lee Chartier's principle, as the temperature increases, equilibrium shifts in endothermic direction. Endothermic direction. So this is according to Lee Chartier's principle. So according to Lee Chartier's principle, as the temperature increases, the equilibrium of the reaction will shift towards the endothermic direction. So based on this statement, since the solubility process is exothermic in nature, as the temperature increases, this solubility will shift towards the back side, so that increasing temperature, the solubility gets decreased in case of exothermic reaction. So if the solubility process is endothermic reaction or endothermic solubilitic reaction, so as the temperature increases, the value of solubility gets increased if the solubility process is endothermic in nature. Okay, so this is nothing but the effect of temperature on the process of solubility. So that means as the temperature increases, if the solubility process is exothermic, increasing temperature decreases the value of solubility. So if the solubility process is endothermic reaction, then increasing temperature increases the value of solubility. So this is nothing but the effect of temperature on the process of solubility. So next we will study the effect of the pressure on the solubility. So effect of pressure. Pressure on solubility. So to explain the effect of pressure on the solubility, so we have to consider one of the solution in which the solute should be gaseous in nature. So if the gaseous solute is dissolved in the liquid solvent, then we are going to explain the effect of pressure on the solubility. The effect of pressure on solubility can be explained by using the gaseous solute in the liquid solvent. That means as the pressure of the gas increases, then we are going to observe the solubility of this gas in the liquid will be more. That means, so if the gas is solute, if the solute is gaseous in nature, so increasing pressure increases the value of this gas in the liquid one. That means as the pressure increases, the value of solubility also gets increased. So to explain this, we have to take one of the solute in the gaseous state. So then we will study, to explain the effect of pressure on the solubility, we are going to study one of the law called Henry's law. So before going to that, we will take one of the solution in which the solute is gas and the solvent is liquid. Gas and liquid. Gas and liquid. That means by the addition of, by the passage of gas into the liquid, we are going to observe the solubility of gas in liquid. So if we want to dissolve more amount of gas into the liquid, we have to increase the pressure. That means if we pass this gas with a higher pressure, so that maximum amount of gas is dissolved in the liquid. So that is explained by using one of the law called Henry's law. So what is the statement of this Henry's law? So this Henry's law is to be studied at the constant temperature by keeping temperature constant. So at constant temperature, the partial pressure of gas in liquid. Partial pressure of gas in liquid. That means we are going to take the liquid as the solvent and we are passing the gas, which is nothing but the solute. So we are passing the gas in the form of solute and we are taking the solvent in liquid state. So by the passage of gas into the liquid, this gas will undergo soluble in this liquid. So if we pass the gas with a higher pressure, so that the maximum amount of gas is dissolved in the liquid, or maximum amount of gas is soluble in the given liquid at a particular temperature. That means at a given temperature, the partial pressure of gas, the partial pressure of gas in the liquid is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the gas in the solution. So whatever the gas that we are passing in the form of solute is dissolved in the liquid, we will get a solution. In that solution, gas will undergo dissolution or solubility. So that the partial pressure of gas in liquid is directly proportional to the mole fraction of the gas in solution. So this is nothing but the statement of Henry's law. So this Henry's law comes under a solution called gas in liquid. So that gas is a solute and liquid is a solvent. So for that, Henry's law can be stated as, at constant temperature, the partial pressure of gas in liquid is directly proportional to the mole fraction of gas in the solution state. So that is the statement of Henry's law. Then we will study the mathematical form of Henry's law. So the partial pressure can be represented as small p. So this partial pressure is directly proportional to the mole fraction of gas in liquid. So mole fraction is represented by the symbol x. X is called the mole fraction. That is, the partial pressure of gas in liquid is directly proportional to the mole fraction of gas in the solution state. So this is nothing but the mathematical form of Henry's law. So you can also write one more equation by removing this proportionality sign. That is, P is equal to, so to remove this proportionality sign, we have to introduce equals and also one of the constant, proportionality constant, that is KH into X. So where P is called the partial pressure of gas in liquid and KH is called the constant, proportionality constant, is also called as Henry's law constant, and X is called the mole fraction of gas in solution. So this is nothing but the mathematical form of Henry's law. So how can we state Henry's law? Henry's law can be defined as, at a constant temperature, the partial pressure of gas in liquid is directly proportional to the mole fraction of gas in the solution state. So the mathematical form of Henry's law can be taken as P is equal to KH into X, where P is called the partial pressure and KH is called the Henry's law constant and X is the mole fraction. So what is the significance of KH? Significance. Significance of KH. So this significance of KH can be explained by using two conditions. That is, higher the value of KH. So if the value of KH is higher, that means if the value of KH is having a larger value, then the value of solubility will be lower. That means these two are inversely proportional to one another. Higher the value of KH, lower will be the solubility. And the second significance of Henry's law constant is KH. If the value of KH is lower, then the solubility will be higher. So higher the value of KH, lower will be the solubility, or lower the value of KH, higher will be the solubility. So this is nothing but the significance of Henry's law constant. Next, what are the applications and what is the application of Henry's law? What is the application of Henry's law? So Henry's law na is used is applied in the sealing of the bottles of soft drink and the soda bottles. That means in what way we are using Hindisla in the sealing of those bottles? That means in the sealing of bottles. That means soda bottle, bottles, soda bottle. So we are going to pass CO2 gas under high pressure. That means the solubility of CO2 gas is increased by making or by sealing the bottles with higher pressure. So if the pressure is more, then the solubility of CO2 gas in those bottles will be more. That means if we pass the gas with a higher pressure, then we can dissolve more amount of CO2 gas into the bottles. So that means this passing of CO2 gas with higher pressure into the bottles of soda bottle or soft drink bottles, we can observe the application of Henry's law